Welcome to the next lecture. In electrical machines, we were discussing the synchronous motor, and in this particular lecture, we'll focus our discussion on effect of excitation on armature current and power factor. So, last few lectures, we were discussing the effect of excitation and the load current, and in this particular lecture, we will see how this excitation is playing a very important and a crucial role to change the armature current and the power factor. So basically, we know that a synchronous motor operates both for the overexcited case and the under-excitation case. So what happens when the synchronous motor is operated under overexcitation case and the under-excitation case? So let us consider a synchronous motor which is having a constant mechanical load. So constant mechanical load means the output is constant and the losses are neglected. So that this discussion will be done under various cases. So case one will be the normal excitation. So under the normal excitation, we know that the back EMF is equal to the supply voltage, and this normal excitation is known as 100% excitation. So in this particular case, if we see the normal excitation case where the induced EMF or the back EMF is equal to the supply voltage, armature current lags the voltage by a small angle phi. So phi being the power factor angle, where the current is lagging the voltage by an angle phi. Whereas the theta, which is the coupling angle, is with respect to the resultant EMF is fixed by the stator constant. So stator constant means the synchronous reactance and the armature resistance. So we can get the value of 10 theta as excess by Ra, that is the imaginary part by real part. If we consider the value of Zs, that is the synchronous impedance, is equal to Ra plus J times excess. So here we can see that the real part is basically the resistance and the imaginary part is the reactance. So we can get the 10 theta value as excess by Ra, that is the imaginary values by real value. Now, case 2 is basically when the motor is operated under the under excitation case, where the value of EV is less than V, excitation is less than 100%. So under the normal excitation case, where the excitation was at 100%, now it has reduced than the 100%, and it is the under excitation case. So here what we see is that the resultant EMF advances in the clockwise direction. So comparing to the case 1, where we discussed the normal excitation case, the case B is basically the under excitation case. So here, if we compare the resultant EMF ER from the first case to the second case, we see that it has rotated in the clockwise direction. And hence, the current which was lagging now also, although it is lagging behind the ER by a fixed angle theta. So it is lagging the resultant EMF by an angle theta. Now the magnitude of the current is increased. So if we compare the magnitude of the current from the first case to the second case, so the magnitude of the current from the first case to the second case has increased and its power factor is decreased because the value of the phase angle has increased. So the phase angle between the voltage and the current has increased. As a result, the power factor has decreased. And the magnitude of the current has increased for the under excitation case. Now, because input, that is the power input, as well as the voltage are constant, hence the power component of the current, that is I cos phi, remains the same. We know that a current will have two components. One is I cos phi and another is I sin phi. So I cos phi component remain the same because the power input and voltage is constant. However, the component I sin phi, that is the wattless component, has increased. Hence, as excitation decreases, because this is the case of the under excitation case, so the excitation has decreased, the current will increase. So the magnitude of the current will increase and power factor will decrease, so that the power component I cos phi is equal to OA remains the constant. So if we see the component OA, that is O is the reference point and A is the point of the current. So here we see that the component of the current I cos phi remains the same, where in for the first case and for the second case. The reason being is that the power and the input voltage are constant, so the component of the current power component is basically constant, whereas the sine phi component has increased. However, we also observe that the locus of the extremity of the current vector is a straight horizontal line. So if we observe the locus of this current vector, it is moving in a straight horizontal line. Incidentally, what happened is that when the field current has reduced, the pull out torque is also reduced in proportion. So in case of the under excitation case, the field current has reduced. Because of reduced excitation, the pull out torque is also reduced in proportion. So we have already discussed this pull out torque in the previous lecture. Case 3 is the final case where the value of the back EMF is greater than the voltage, so it is basically an over excitation case. Here, if we compare, the value of the resultant EMF is pulled anti-clockwise and so is the current. So compared to the previous case, if we see these two cases, it was rotating in the clockwise direction, taking the normal excitation as the reference. Now for the over excitation case, it has reduced in the anti-clockwise direction. So first it was in the clockwise direction when we have discussed the under excitation case, but for the over excitation case, it has moved in the anti-clockwise direction, and so is the value of the current. Now the motor is drawing a leading current. So motor is drawing a leading current because it is the over excitation case. For some value of the excitation, that current may be in phase with the voltage, that is power factor is unity. So there will be some value of excitation under the over excitation case where the power factor is unity. It means that the current and voltage are in phase with each other. So that is a special case. At that time, the current drawn by the motor would be the minimum. So compared to all these cases, if you compare the normal excitation and the under excitation case, and a special case of over excitation case where the current and voltage are in phase with each other, so here the current will be the minimum quantity. So having discussed these points of the excitation, so two important points stand out clearly from the prevailing discussion. So the discussion that we were doing now, what are the important points? So the first important point is basically there is a relationship between the armature current versus the field current. So armature current and field current, there is a direct relationship. So what is the relationship that we found out? That the magnitude of the current varies with excitation. So we see that when excitation changes, obviously the magnitude of the current changes and has large value for both low and high values of excitation. So whether it is a normal excitation or it is a over and under excitation current, the value of the current changing with excitation and it has a large value. Though it is lagging for low excitation and leading for higher excitation. Means the phase angle of the current with respect to the voltage is changing, but the magnitude is larger. In between, it has a minimum value corresponding to a certain excitation. So between the lagging excitation and the leading excitation, somewhere in the minimum, where the minimum is taking place at certain value of the excitation, where the it is under for the over excitation case. Well, for the over excitation case, there is a certain amount of the excitation where the current will be the minimum. The variation of the current with excitation is known as the V curve. So the relationship between the armature current versus field current will give you a curve which is known as the V curve because of their shape. So if we draw a curve where the y-axis is basically the armature current and the x-axis is basically the field current, then for the different loading conditions, we will be getting the shape of the curve as the V form. So this is for the full load condition, this is for half load, and this is for no load condition. For different loading condition, the variation of the armature current with the field current is in the form of a V curve. So it is known as the V curves. Now there will be a certain point where the current will be minimum, and before that, this on the left hand side it will be a lagging power factor, and on the right hand side it will be a leading power factor case. The second point that we are going to discuss from the prevailing discussions is the relationship between the power factor and the field current. So here we have discussed the armature current versus field current. Now we are going to discuss the relationship between the power factor versus field current. So on the y-axis we will be having the power factor, and on the x-axis we will be having the field current. For the same input, so if we keep the power input as same, the current is varying over a wide range. So we know that keeping the power constant, the current will vary, and so the power factor also accordingly. So with the varying excitation is varied with respect to the field current, the current is changing and the power factor is also changing. When over excited, so when the motor is running at a over excitation case, then it runs with a leading power factor and with a lagging power factor under the under excitation case. So two cases we have discussed, one is over excited, another is under excited cases. So for over excited case, the machine is running under the leading power factor condition, whereas for the under excitation case, the machine is running for the lagging power factor condition. In between, if we compare, the power factor is unity. So if we see the curve for the power factor on the y-axis and the field current on the x-axis, then the curve is basically looking like an inverted V. So here we get the variation of the power factor with excitation, and it is an inverted V curve. So first we get the V curve, which is between the armature current and the field current. Then we get inverted V curve, which is the relationship between the power factor and the field current. And when the current is minimum, so on the left hand side, we'll be having a lagging power factor. So for the lagging power factor, as the field current has increased, the power factor will increase. Now, as the power factor become leading, we see that the curve has decreased. So the power factor will decrease. So different curve has been shown for the full load condition, half full load condition, and the no load condition. So in this particular lecture, we have discussed how the excitation plays an important role in changing the armature current and the power factor. Thank you for now. See you in the next lecture.